Hello everyone, Xenu and Zimmer here, and welcome back to Let's Play Fire Emblem. I'm having delays on my controller, really. Last time, we were just roaming around the place. This time, we're doing the mission. Got here. Inheritance.
Thank you.
Say, Teach, this must be the tower, don't you think? You know, even for a tower, it's pretty, towering.
It's more like a fortress.
It's a remnant of ancient wars. Those thieves certainly found themselves a great place to nest. I hear their leader Miklan is a former noble. It makes sense that he would already know about this place.
Several hundred years ago, this was an important stronghold for defusing invasions from the north. Back then, this tower was built for both surveillance and defense. It will be difficult to seize it.
Gilbert, isn't it? You hail from the kingdom, right? No wonder you're so knowledgeable. While we're chatting so amicably, do you mind if I ask some questions?
I don't mind. If I can answer them, I will.
Have you ever seen the Lance of Ruin?
I have. A long time ago. It was an impressive, if not eerily ominous, weapon to behold. According to Margrave Gautier, Miklan has used the lance to turn the tables on his pursuers.
Is that right? Then those without a crest can use it as well. Interesting. As far as I knew, that wasn't possible. And then we have the mythical Sword of the Creator, which can't be used by anyone except Teach, crest or no crest. Maybe you're just that special, Teach. Or maybe there's something you're not telling us. Either way, I expect big things from you in this battle.
I'm relying on you, Claude.
Are you now? Then why don't you hand over the Sword of the Creator for a bit? Then again, it would just be a heavy blade in my hands. There's no justice in this world, Teach. The rain is really coming down now. Let's finish this quickly.
Yeah, let's do it. Okay. Oh, sorry. We can move Claude now, finally.
The enemy is close by. We're almost to the top floor.
Phew. Why did we have to climb so high before a battle? At least it's better than fighting in heavy rain. Ready and willing.
Who, me?
I got this.
I stand ready.
Stay focused. Let's get to it.
Now I've got to be careful.
Leave it to me. Who, me?
Ready anytime.
Thank you.
Magnificent.
Here.
The captain's in trouble. Hurry up, you fools!
Enemies approach from the lower floors. Watch the rear flank.
We'll leave that to you, Gilbert.
Still far from my best.
Now raise your blade and knock your arrows. The time has come for the final battle.
It's not luck, it's fate.
We've got a chess key. Let's move up.
Think carefully.
Now!
This is my duty.
Chest. Armor Slayer. We'll get rid of the Iron Sword, because that would be useful. Arises from the tavern core.
Plenty more where that came from.
Slowly does it as we climb this tower. Slow and steady. Forward.
I'm no stranger to battle.
Thanks for that.
Here we go! Attack them from both sides!
It's an ambush!
Now's our chance!
Let's think carefully.
Gotta use your head sometimes.
Thank you.
one down.
Trivial victory.
You underestimated me.
Worth a try.
Gilbert's going to
gotta do what you gotta do.
Yet to
give it your all. And that good form. That takes care of that. Just worked harder.
Let's get held up there. Okay, so we just need to get her down there. Something that's down there. Let's move on.
Thank you.
Enough level up.
Is this?
Yes. It is Marianne.
Thank you.
strategies.
Ready and willing.
Let's get to it. Who, me? Stay focused.
I got this.
Battle. I stand ready.
Okay.
Leave it to me.
Ender.
Ready anytime.
Who, me?
I did!
Ring of accuracy, that might be useful.
This is what I do.
Move forward.
Should have trained better. Armor Slayer.
That is that.
You're outclassed.
Thank you. Lysippia. There's still. Nice.
I got this.
Actually, what am I doing? I should be just be doing this.
Hey, I got an idea. Down to this.
I stand ready. You can't compete with me.
I mean the cat, nope. Lawrence.
Leave it to me. You underestimated me.
Ready anytime.
6-9.
Ready and willing.
So the crater.
Sorry, the victory is mine. Progress suits me well.
Nice. Model leader. What? More just because... or something else. You know what? Let's try and get over as many people with some injuries. In front of Lysippia.
So, you think you can take the lance from me? I'll kill you. I'll kill every last one of you!
And he's taking damage. Interesting. Thank you.
mindful.
Ruptured heaven. We'll do it from range. But after... God, come on. After Claude, it's a bit more experience.
Never under.
Never hurts to get more experience. Time to prove Seraph.
No hesitation.
Oh my god. Oof. A lot of experience.
Not bad for your kind. A bunch of spoiled, rotten children. What the hell?
First time fighting such a thing? An evil power has caused them to grow quite large. Their life force is beyond a mortal like yourself. You cannot win, unless... Even if you've cornered one, you cannot let... Can you see that barrier? A strong attack, if you can... It cannot...
You must break...
If you break without
these.
The power, they have... Attack them! Be on your... Once they have distracted... But you should be conquering them.
I still love it.
How awful. Can't even.
And all our party is over here. Let's heal up Byleth. Let's use Raphael to pull them in. Or Hilda, if it's one to go for her.
Stay focused.
Won't try and maneuver everyone to different positions. Mount. Over here. Okay. Now let's go. Oof, we actually got lucky. That was not in our favor. These guys are still coming after us? Really? Gambit. We didn't waste Gambit yet.
I'm here to help.
All for this.
Everything is ready.
Push the deck. Back beast intention.
Incoming.
Pull out all the stops.
Got broke it. We've got some umbral steel. And we can attack it without fearing counterattack. So for said, we'll have to break it more times.
Time for seconds.
Apparently we'll defeat it before it gets to even break out of its daze. Seraphim.
Goddess, the beast is gone, yet Miklan and the lance remain.
We defeated him somehow. Let's grab the lance and return to the monastery.
Not how I wanted this fight to end, but... Hey, I'll take it.
That man... His form was changed. It was as though that lance was swallowing him whole. Upon that sight, it makes sense that your students were upset. I wonder if those relics truly hide such power. Yet even still, that power seems familiar. That form as well. As one who wields the sword of the Creator, does that mean you possess that power too?
Professor, you have returned. The goddess is indeed generous with her divine protection. I have already heard Gilbert's report about what happened. See to it that you keep what transpired at the tower to yourself. People would lose faith in the nobles should rumors spread of one using a relic and transforming into a monster. All regions of Fodland would fall into chaos. We must avoid that at all costs. Please ensure the students who accompanied you understand that as well. Have I made myself clear?
Yes, of course.
His transformation into a black beast was nothing short of divine punishment from the goddess. Punishment for someone arrogant and foolish enough to use a hero's relic even though they were unworthy and unqualified.
You knew?
Of course. That is why we rushed to recover it. Sadly, we did not arrive in time. The church will formally return the lance to House Gautier, if you would. You have my gratitude. I can see that I was right to trust you with this. Please report back. I will tell you of your new mission for the coming moon at that time.
Nice work, Teach. It's thanks to you that we successfully completed our mission. As for Miklan, I wonder if he really believed he could wield a relic.
Hard to say.
I bet he just wanted to get his hands on it, even though he knew he couldn't use it. Though I'm sure he wasn't counting on turning into a monster like that. I wonder if that monster represents another aspect of the hero's relics. What a strange and terrifying power.
Seems so.
Stories of misfortune have followed the hero's relics since ancient times.
Tomas, you've caught me by surprise. That's not easy to do. Though I suppose I should have expected to see our librarian in his library.
I am sorry to intrude. I simply heard you speaking of the hero's relics. I can tell you more about them if you'd like. The story goes that Nemesis was corrupted by evil because of the sword of the Creator. Other heroes also lost themselves by continuing to use the relics, transforming into black beasts with twisted souls. There used to be a great many records regarding the dark history of the relics.
Used to be.
They have been destroyed across all of Fodlan, stripped from their shelves, including those that resided at this very library.
You make it sound like the church is covering up the truth. But now that you mention it, Rhea was very specific about not wanting anyone to find out what happened at Conan Tower. Hey, Tomas, why are you telling us all of this?
It seemed like you were searching for answers about the relics. What is a librarian if not a guide in the search for knowledge? And not only have you been searching, but you have been doing so through the night. I would suggest you stop before the night's notice. And that is enough meddling for today. Please excuse me.
So I've been found out, have I? I suppose I do spend more time at the library than most students. But I won't stop. I can't afford to.
Who are you after?
Teach. You don't really expect me to tell you something so personal just like that, do you? Though,
yes.
I wouldn't mind sharing if you were to tell me some of your secrets in exchange.
I can't let this exchange pass without comment. If you're sharing secrets, perhaps I can share one as well?
Are you sure you could survive that? I'd say you're the least likely to share secrets out of everyone at the Academy.
Coming from you, I'll take that as a compliment. After all, you're easily the student with the most secrets.
I'm afraid you overestimate me. My secrets don't amount to much. But back to Teach.
Don't try to change the subject, Claude. We're talking about secrets. Yours. Who is your father? And why did you appear so suddenly as if from nowhere? Duke Regan's eldest son died in an accident. Having tragically lost other family members as well, he was without an heir. The Alliance would undoubtedly have been shaken if House Regan had lost its position of leadership. But then you showed up. Why did you return to House Regan? What brought you to the monastery?
He doesn't have to answer to you.
Alas, to be surrounded by women as lovely as flowers only to be pricked by their thorns. My dream, in truth, is a selfless dream, but I require power to make it a reality. When I learned about the power of my crest, I knew I had a chance. So I'm chasing that dream, to the bitter end, if need be. I came to this monastery because I thought I might find someone useful, someone to help me on my path. So, what do you think? If you promise to help me achieve my dream, no matter what, I'll promise to tell you anything.
I have my own dream to tend to. I pray that yours does not interfere with mine.
What about you, Teach?
If it's a noble dream.
I see. Well, now isn't the time to discuss this. You are still my Teach, after all.
Professor, you have done well to complete such a difficult task. You have shown exceptional skill in leading your students. I am forever grateful for the safe return of the hero's relic. Just as I expected, you have mastered the sword of the Creator. Now then, I shall tell you about your mission for the coming month.
Rhea, Archbishop!
Setith, what troubles you?
Flayne is missing. I cannot find her anywhere.
Oh.
Professor, have you seen Flayne recently?
I have not.
I have searched everywhere. Where could she be? She may be in danger. Oh, no, no, no. What am I to do?
Calm yourself, Setith. Professor, we shall continue our discussion another time.
And with that, next time, since we are on a mystery hunt, finding Flame. could have kidnapped her. Because, let's be real, it's a video game. She's not going to be somewhere random in the monastery. This is Zeno and Zuma, signing out.